Have you ever wanted to improve the thermal performance of your 3D printer? Today, we're going to be talking about exactly that. Hey, I'm Dan Baruce, the CEO and co-founder of Slice Engineering, and today we're going to be talking about boron nitride base, why you should use this compound in your 3D printer, and why NASA is using it for the Mars and lunar missions coming up in the next decade. We get a lot of questions about this product, what it is, what it does, what it's for, and so we'll talk a little bit about that today. Boron nitride paste is boron and nitride, two compounds that you can find on the periodic table, at least the boron part. Nitrides, of course, nitrogen and some other things. Has a lot of really unique properties that a lot of other things don't. Has very high thermal stability, up to 2000 degrees Celsius before it starts to decay. Not many materials can do that. And it also has really high thermal conductivity, which means it conducts heat. You know, if you've got heat in one place and not in the other, you want to get it to the other spot. You can use boron nitride paste like you would certain metals, for example. It also is not electrically conductive, which is another unique property of boron nitride. For all those reasons, NASA actually is experimenting with the use of boron nitride paste, or boron nitride in general, for setting up test enclosures or living spaces on the moon and Mars. So someday, if and when we have people living on the moon and on Mars, likely the inner lining of these habitats will be made from boron nitride, which is pretty cool. There's a few different forms of boron nitride. There are hexagonal forms, like the one I talked about a little bit ago. There are cubic forms, which is essentially another formulation, and an amorphous form, where the molecules are shifting differently within a suspension. So in our case, we are using a paste where there's a lot of the hexagonal molecules suspended in an aqueous or water-based solution. So it's a bunch of water, a bunch of boron nitride, and when the water evaporates, you end up with just boron nitride, what allows you to get the effective heat conduction and lack of electrical conductivity or an electrical insulator. We use boron nitride paste at Slice to ensure even heat distribution in hot blocks and to help improve printing performance and efficiency. Like I mentioned, it's not electrically conductive, which is great because you can use it for installing a heater and a sensor and not have to worry about shorting out your heater or sensor or potentially causing an electrically unsafe condition with your 3D printer. It's also inert, which is fantastic. So it doesn't interact with any metals like steel, aluminum, or copper alloys that would be in your hot end or the things surrounding it. It does not have any degradation impact on plastics. If you get it on your hands, it doesn't cause a problem. In fact, it's safe enough that you might be able to even eat it. I wouldn't suggest that. Probably cause a lot of indigestion, but it's a very safe and inert compound, which is great when you're dealing with high temperature stuff and sometimes compounds that are not as safe. Boron nitride in our solution is an aqueous suspension, our paste. It's essentially water, mostly water, with all these boron nitride particles floating in the water. That's how it comes in the syringe, or the big boy syringe, with mostly, like you mentioned, water and then the boron nitride particles suspended in that water. And when the paste is heated, the water actually evaporates and it leaves this highly conductive paste. In our literature, say that we get about 31 watts per meter Kelvin at 100 degrees Celsius. Of course, as the temperature changes, the thermal conductivity changes as well. We're also, as I mentioned, using hexagonal boron nitride, which is the highest thermal conductivity of the three types. And you imagine the molecules, you know, lining up in a plane. When those molecules align, they actually have really high thermal conductivity between 200 and 400 watts per meter Kelvin, which is similar to like copper alloy. When the paste is being extruded out of a syringe or applied with a little applicator, you're not going to get perfect planar layers in the molecular region. So we quote a much lower number for that reason. But in your actual application, if you could zoom in really close at the paste, you'd see some areas that have aligned planes where you're going to see higher thermal conductivity and some areas where it's sort of jumbled and the thermal conductivity isn't going to be quite as high. Of course, that's molecular level, so a little hard to control that in our application in 3D printing, but it is a cool thing to know exactly what's happening on that tiny micro scale, nanoscale, as you're applying this compound. There are a lot of different applications for boron nitride and boron nitride paste specifically. Boron nitride can be used as a heat sink material, actually. There are certain composite versions that are used for heat dissipation in the semiconductor industry, which is really cool. NASA wants to use it for habitats on Mars and on the moon. They're currently using it in high temperature furnaces where the interior lining of the furnace is actually made from boron nitride because it does such a good job of reflecting the heat back into the furnace and maintaining that temperature. It's also used in certain applications as a high temperature lubricant where there are rotating parts and it's a high temperature rotating process like a high speed bearing or something, and you need to keep the temperature down. Boron nitride paste or certain formulations of boron nitride can be used in those applications. Another, of course, very normal application and one that we use it for is for heat transfer in a temperature sensing application. So for example, I've heard of a thermal well. A thermal well is just a pipe essentially with a cap on it where a temperature sensor is inserted inside, and that pipe serves to preserve the temperature sensor from rushing fluids like chemical fluids in a manufacturing plant or oil in an oil and gas application where you may be pumping a bunch of lubricants or harsh chemicals and need to get it down into an oil rig, or you're pumping oil out and you need to maintain or monitor the temperature of those fluids as they're passing by, but you don't want to destroy the temperature sensor. Thermal wells are used for that application, and thermal wells are good because you can protect them, but not so great because they don't get as accurate of a reading of the fluid. You can solve that problem by filling the thermal well with boron nitride paste and then potting in the temperature sensor, and that gives you a much better conductivity from the outer surface of the thermal well into the interior surface where the temperature sensor is. You get that better feedback in the thermal well in an oil and gas or, again, a chemical processing plant. Similarly, boron nitride paste is used for potting heater cartridges into a block or injection molding. And just like the two applications that I mentioned, thermal wells and injection molding with sensors and heater cartridges, that's why we use boron nitride paste for 3D printing. Because guess what? 3D printing has temperature sensors and heater cartridges in a pretty small confined area, and you want to improve the conductivity of the heater to better get heat out into the block, and that improves the lifespan of the heater. The lifespan of a heater is limited by heat, essentially. The materials inside of the heater break down and eventually allow air penetration into the heater and the coil breaks. And boron nitride can help extend that life and prevent the heater from breaking down prematurely. And then on the sensor side, you get more accurate sensing because you don't have an air gap between, and air of course is an insulator in this case, you don't have an air gap between the sensor and the block, so you get better readings on the sensor and you get better heat dissipation from the heater into the block, which improves your performance of the feedback loop between the heater and the sensor in your 3D printer. And that's a good thing. We use boron nitride paste in our 3D printers for installing heaters and temperature sensors into hot blocks, as opposed to leaving an air gap. This has a benefit over using a clamp, for example, or a retaining screw, in the fact that you're not applying pressure, in the case of a retaining screw, on the outer cartridge of the sensor or heater, which could cause premature failure and degradation. And you're also not applying what's called a hoop stress, or a stress around the circumference of the heater or sensor, like what you get in a clamp, which also, of course, reduces the life of the sensor or the heater. And we want to avoid premature failures, obviously. The less time you have to spend taking heaters and sensors in and out of your 3D printer, the better. Another benefit of that type of setup is that it creates a tighter seal and help protect the heater and sensor against vibration and thermal expansion and shocks as the printer cycles through, obviously, room temperature up to printing temperatures. So we recommend using boron nitride paste on heaters and sensors on the exterior of the cartridge and on the interior cartridge holes in the hot block of your hot end on your 3D printer. There are some cases where if you have a disassembled hot end, it might make sense also to apply on the heat break or on the nozzle threads, depending on how your printer is set up and if you are seeing heat creep on the heatsink side of your hot end. Boron nitride paste may help eliminate that issue. If you want to install this into your 3D printer hot end, you will basically remove the hot end and the heater and sensor, You're going to take the swabs that come with the boron nitride paste, apply some to the exterior of the heater, coat the interior of the hot block, the holes for the heater cartridge and the temperature sensor, and then you will insert the heater cartridge and temperature sensor back into the block and allow it to dry. You can speed this up by heating the hot end up after reinstallation to 100 degrees Celsius to get the water to come out. If it's fully capped and you end up getting some steam coming out, basically forcing the water out rapidly, it can create a little bit of a mess. Thankfully, boron nitride paste is water soluble, comes in an aqueous solution, so it's pretty easy to remove with a little bit of water and a wet cloth. Just like you can remove the boron nitride paste with a wet cloth, you can also do the same thing with dry boron nitride paste by getting it a little bit wet. We get questions all the time. Okay, I've potted my cartridge heater into the hot block. It's a great potting compound. Now, how do I get it back out? We've got a handy little printable tool that you can get on our website. It's called Heater Unseater, and you can use that with our mosquito hot ends to essentially serve as a little wrench to pop the heater back out. But you could also use something like a screwdriver or a pick to knock it out if it's in a place where you can't get a little bit of a rotational effort on it to break the bonds, the internal bonds of the boron nitride particles, and get it to come loose. Again, if you want to clean up afterwards from dry boron nitride paste or wet boron nitride paste, a wet cloth will usually do the job pretty well. So to sum it up, why should you use boron nitride paste with your 3D printer? You improve thermal conductivity between the heater cartridge and the hot block, which can help draw more power and performance out of your existing hot end. You can get better thermal conductivity between the hot block and the temperature sensor, which improves the responsiveness of your 3D printer. And there are also numerous other areas of the 3D printer, anywhere where you need heat transfer to happen efficiently, where boron nitride paste is of enormous benefit. If you want to optimize the performance of your current 3D printer, a very inexpensive and easy to use upgrade, boron nitride paste is something you should definitely consider. If you enjoyed this style of educational video, be sure to like and subscribe. Let us know down below in the comments what other content you would like to see from us or other questions you may have about boron nitride paste. We would love to answer those. And be sure to check out our free guide, 7 things you should not do with your 3D printer, down in the description below. Also, as always, don't forget to stay zesty.